can't you see? Welcome back to BT. Sometimes just throwing out batteries is toxic. That's the song for Britney, right? Toxic? Right. I know music. Welcome back. How does recycling our batteries help protect our environment? Call to Recycle is Canada's leading organization for battery collection and recycling with 25 years of experience and has collected almost 40 million kilograms of used batteries since 1997. That's a staggering number. Joining us now is John McQuaid, Vice President, Marketing and Communications at Call to Recycle, to tell us why it is so important to recycle your batteries and how easy it is to do. John, welcome to the show.
Morning, Sid. Thanks for having me.
Full disclosure, my wife, who I love deeply, has been on recycling batteries for as long as I've known her. I haven't been as strong, but she has converted me over to this in terms of how important it is. How important is it? Because I don't think it's top of mind for most people when it comes to recycling.
Super important, and I'll first start off by saying do not throw batteries in the garbage. Believe it or not, the average household has up to 100 batteries in use at one time.
I believe it.
Laptops, cell phones, key fobs, chargers, you name it, kids' toys. So there's three very important reasons why batteries should be recycled. The first is they can hold a residual charge. So if they're disposed of improperly, they can pose a risk. The second reason is a major environmental benefit. So batteries are corrosive. So if they end up in landfill, the toxic chemicals can leach into the water and the soil, and that's just not good. And the third reason is a major economic benefit. So contributing to a circular economy. So there's precious metals and materials in batteries that can be reused to make new products. So think stainless steel appliances, golf clubs, even bicycles. And at Call to Recycle, our mission is just to make sure Canadians know how important it is to recycle batteries, and it's easy to do so.
Now, but it isn't as simple as, okay, in the recycle bin it goes, right? It's a bit more involved. How do you do it?
Yeah, it's a fascinating journey, and I think the most important step is to get those dead batteries out of your home. So we have over 10,000 convenient drop-off locations across Canada. And when I'm talking batteries, I'm talking your typical AA's, AAA's, C's, D's, power tool batteries, cell phone batteries. So that's the first step. Get them to one of our drop-off locations. The second step is they're then taken to one of our sorting partners where they're sorted into clean streams based on weight, size, and chemistry. And then once that is done, they're then taken to one of our processing partners, either here in Ontario or across Canada, where the components are then broken down and recycled properly.
So where can we find the drop? I didn't realize there were that many drop-off locations.
Yeah, there's plenty of options, right? So go to recycleyourbatteries.ca, and you could put in your postal code and find which one is nearest to you. We work with awesome partners like Rexall, Canadian Tire, Home Depot.
Heard of them, yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Big, awesome retailers. Also municipalities. So here in Ontario and across Canada, we have great municipal partners. And we're just trying to find cool, innovative ways to make it easier to recycle batteries. So we have these little personal collection cubes that you can store your batteries, and then when ready, take them to a drop-off location. And later this year, we're deploying this this smart container that looks like a big battery, and it uses some pretty neat technology to let us know when the bins are full and ready for pickup, and some safety enhancements to go along with it. So again, tomorrow's Earth Day. We want to encourage all Canadians to recycle your batteries, not just tomorrow, but every day, and protect the environment, and go to recycleyourbatteries.ca to learn more.
Well, hopefully you've charged people up in an effort to recycle their batteries. But from the municipality standpoint, because I'm in Peel Region in and around Southern Ontario here, it's on the calendar, the pickup calendar. There's a specific battery pickup day. You probably have missed it. Pay attention to it. Because it's now, again, I've gotten a lot more into this than I used to. It's important. It's very important. And it's the drop-offs are great, and a lot of municipalities also help out as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, John. You a Leaf fan?
Big time. Big win. Big win. Tomorrow night's a big game.
Will they have the batteries charged up tomorrow?
Okay. That's it.
Can I get more battery puns into this conversation? Nope. I'm going to walk away from it. John, good stuff. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Sid. Thanks for having
me. All right, we're going to take a break. You sound off coming up. Kev, are we doing the plane thing for sound off?
Yeah.
How do you handle conflict on an airplane? We're seeing videos. This is a professional show we're doing here. How do you handle conflict on an airplane? We're seeing videos like every other day of arguments taking place and having it have a lot of repercussions, not just for the people involved, but for the other people on the plane. How do you resolve or handle it? 1-866-267-3797. More BT coming up.